Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Brandy and this is Beautifly Bargains. I am going to share with you a jewelry haul, huge jewelry haul that I received from a seller back east in Nova Scotia. And I think I paid, I don't know what I paid, like 30 bucks anyways, but it came this huge bag. So we have all this to share, so I'm not sure if what's all in here. I know I did see some really cool vintage items, and then there are 1, 2, 3, 4 boxes and a few cool pieces in here from what I can see. And yeah, let's get right into it. If you're new, thank you for joining me. I appreciate you. I hope you'll subscribe. I am running a giveaway still, so it's still open for anybody who subscribes to my channel. I do plan on picking a winner soon. I am just trying to up my subscribers. There is 3 prizes, and soon. I don't know how soon, but soon we will be picking winners for that. Right now, let's just jump right into this jewelry, because it is quite a lot, and so let's do it. This is a paperclip bookmark, and that's cool. I like that. Oh, this is really cool. I like that one. It's connected in the center. I apologize, I haven't been active very much. I've been trying to, I painted my bedroom and all the things. So I've been busy doing all that stuff. I was going to do a video and put up on my channel as well, but I know that's quite a bit different content than what you're used to. This is really pretty. It's like wood on this side, and then it has shell on this side. It fits really nice, too. I really like this. Cool. Cool, cool. We've got some little dainty earrings. Let's see what we got in here. Oh, I got a whole nother little bag of stuff. Oh, look at this. Yeah, this is pretty. This looks like some wire wrapping. Oh, wow, that is beautiful. Isn't that nice? Okay, I like that. There's a little pair of earrings on the card. This one just looks like it's fashion. I don't know. I don't see any signatures. Ooh, it's got something going on here. We'll have to get that cleaned up, see if we can clean that up. Let me just see if I spray some water. What that does to it. It almost just kind of looks like, I don't know if it's makeup or if it's, that's a cool bracelet though, and that is glass. That could be real turquoise. Huh, I'm going to try cleaning this guy up, because this here looks, this is glass. I'm just wondering what that blue would be, like, is it makeup? Possibly, who knows? We'll get it cleaned up though. Ooh, lots of pretty shiny things. Look how pretty that one is. I like the colors. That's a nice one. Some nice pendants. And then we got a vintage bracelet. It isn't signed, but it's got like a three little leaf. It looks like a snake, a heart. That's kind of cool. Nice. And this is one of those magnetic ones. This one will be going into a lot for sure. I need to create some more jewelry jars, which is why I bought this entire lot, if I'm being honest. So I can make some more jars up. I'm completely out. Actually, no. I've got this guy that I'm currently working on filling. And then I have a couple more in the living room. I always check these because you never know when they're actually silver. Well, they're magnetic, so I guess they're not silver, darlings. Oh, this is a pretty one. Look at all these little crystals and turquoise beads. It's a nice shine to it. I like it. I like it a lot. This one is a clamper style gold tone. Fashion piece, not signed. Nice little design. Ooh, look at this guy. This one's pretty. That's a nice one for stacking. And then we got Caprice, a vintage stretchy watch. Super cool. I am a reseller on Poshmark, so I do a lot of sourcing on Poshmark, and then I sell on Poshmark. I may consider going back on other platforms. This is plastic, so it's like a resin. I don't know, it's actually cold to the touch. Beautiful little cuff, green. See the metal in there? Like, it's really nice. Huh. So yeah, I find a lot of stuff on Poshmark to sell on Poshmark. But I'm thinking about doing more Whatnot sales. But I'm not a live seller. Like, I'm not one for that. I don't know why. It's a lot of, live selling is a lot of work, and you need the space to be able to come and go from it and not have to clean it up after every show where, because like I don't have a dedicated space. But this is beautiful. I really like this guy. This one's really, really, really nice. This is vintage too. Look at that. It's in really beautiful condition. Some of these pieces I will be able to kind of like take the one off and do some little bit of research. Now this one looks like it would have a stamp, but I could be wrong. See in there, like, you see how it's got that little plate? Well, it's just where it connects, I guess. That's a cute little one. Da, 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 da. Lots of bracelets. My son and I were trying to figure this one out. So you see how it opens up? And then once you put it on your wrist, it snaps together. Like, I thought that was cool. And then, I'm going to kind of shine it up a little bit. Somebody got their gravy. They got the gravy on there. I used to say that all the time in my older videos. When I find gravy on the jewelry. Could be anything now, but I like calling it gravy for some reason. I was trying to figure out if this was a J, a T, or a J. What do y'all think it is? T or J? But look at the mechanics of this guy. This is an older piece for sure. Really cute. For a baby. It's for the babies. And then we got this bad boy. This is signed Sarah Coventry, I believe. Yeah, Sarah Cove. These are plastic beads, but what a chandelier. This would be amazing if it were glass beads, but it would probably be too heavy. I'd like to see what this goes with. Let's see if I have a necklace to put on it. And then we got another little bangle bracelet. I should put all these together. And then this is just a little beaded bracelet. Good condition. I'll probably put that into a jar. Most of this will go into a jar, into my jarring stuff. I should do a video while I'm doing them. Holy Jodroby, look at this guy. These are plastic beads also. They're really big though. These are really cute. Lots going on there. These are not tiny little baby roses. And this is like, I don't know, really cheap. I feel like it's not, not a quality piece. Maybe one you would hang in your car. Yeah, it's just plastic. Plastic. All right, and then this is one of these magnetic bracelets. Stainless steel. Looks like it's got a gold plate. I don't know what I would do with that. Maybe make a the other pieces in there. Because, like, that don't really go together, do it? Darlings. Now, what is this? Is there something missing here? This is a tie clip, and it says something USA. Let's see what the camera says. What? Hickok? Anyways, this is kind of cool, but like, it's something missing in there. What would this be for? It's like a sword. You put your tie in there. I'm not sure. I'll have to look that up. And here is a pretty nice bracelet. Looks like it's been worn. Lots of wear on that one, actually. That's a nice little vintage bracelet. Nice color. Nice and shiny. this is pretty. It's sizable. Is there something on it? It's almost like it needs to be cleaned somehow. It's like soldered onto the ring. That's kind of cool. Okay, we like you. This is just a plastic fashion ring. A fashion ring. Oh, this is a hair clip. And it is a peacock. And that's kind of cool. I guess it could be any kind of clip. Oh no, it's hair. Oh. Pretty. Okay, I see you. That's pretty. And we got a red bracelet. Oh, look at this guy. Cardinal, but look how tiny this is. Stainless steel back. It's missing its little chained lock. Oh my god, this thing is still really pretty. Oh, I think there's like some kind of season happening there. The gravy got in there. The gravy's in there. Got it seized up. That's so tiny. Like, look how it's like goes on my fingernail. So tiny. Compared. And this one's tiny. How cool is that? Alright. Oh, it's funny. I was just looking at one of these and I realized, like, these are old. Like, really old. From the 30s. And this one's signed on the back. Can you see what that says? What is all that? EX Exquisite. There is some gravy in there. Let me see if I can get the gravy out. Let me get the gravy out of there. Get that gravy out. Your handy dandy toothbrush. It's almost like a little bit of a there we go. Get that gravy off. My partner has gone to soccer with my kid, and this is his first year playing. He's going to be nine in June. Or, sorry, eight in June. His sister's going to be nine in June. And this is his first time playing, like, in any sport or whatever. So, he's really loving it, and I'm so happy. Now, I'm pretty sure, like, this represents, like, a birthday flower. And, yeah, I'm gonna, this is definitely an older piece, and I love it. I'm gonna say it, put that one up there with the favorites. And then this guy is a pill container. You open it up there, and then you put whatever down in there. Close her back up. But there's some stones missing, unfortunately. But this is from the 30s. The 1930s, 1940s. So she's been around a while, friends. I believe both of these pieces are. And I got a feeling this is an older piece. I thought it was Great Britain pounds, GBP. So I'm wondering if this is from the UK. Eaton, $4.99. Maybe not. Eaton's. Where's Eaton's? Eaton. This guy has seen better days too. Like, he could definitely have a good scrub-a-dub. If you took the time to clean this stuff up though, every little piece, like, this is old. Like, obviously this is really old. But you can bring it back to life pretty quickly. Like, look how fast that's shining back up. Just with some little bit of water and a little toothbrush. Right? This reminds me of, like, men's jewelry that they used to wear back in the 90s. You know, the big heavy stuff. This is Kim. Hello, Kim. Nice to meet you. Do we have any Kims in the house? That's a nice little bracelet. Nice little vintage bracelet in good condition. And then the clasp on that guy is cool. They open up like this. Oh, and it says Japan on the inside. And Japan on that side. And then you put them in there. And there you have it. Thanks, Kim. Oh, I like that. It's really nice. Oh, wow. I love bingo. Oh, this is a nice looking watch, but I think it's been worn. It'll go in my watch lot. So most of this just looks like vintage and then fashion jewelry. And it's perfect for what I need. It'll go well with filling up these jars, you know. Yeah, I usually sell the jars. Depending on if it's craft, wearable, or a mix. And the size, anywhere from 25 up to 50. And then I have a $75 lot as well. And like, the higher the price, the more valuable or the more quality of jewelry you're going to get. Depending on this, like, the size or whatever. But look at that. Hello? Sorry, I'm sidetracked right now, but this is pretty. This one is really nice. I always get so nervous with pieces like this, though, because they're literally just glued on there. And then how easy it would be for it to come apart. But I love wearing this type of jewelry because the stones, they give off good energy vibe. These are really pretty. Look at that quartz. This one's really nice. Look at that blue guy. Oh my god, look at that. Pretty. And we got Charlottetown. PEI. Charlottetown. Prince Edward Island. Here's another fashion bracelet. And this one has, I think that's the letter M. Darlings. Is that the letter M? Yeah. Okay. Now this is a scarf clip. That looks like Sarah Coventry kind of piece to me. That's not so. Oh yeah, it is. Sarah Cov. Don't think I don't know my stuff, y'all. I knew that was Sarah Coventry the second I laid eyes on it. Go, Brandy. Go, Brandy. This is a little vintage bracelet. And then this is a cute little guy, too. Look at all these little crystals in there. Oh. It's all magnetic. So all these little tiny beads look like they're actual crystals. Somebody did some nice work with this. But it's hard to keep it. Oh, that is really cool, actually. What a good piece that is. Look at that. Look at the gold stone. Okay, I like this bracelet a lot. It wouldn't fit me, though. It kind of curls up, but that's because of the magnets, right? Like, the magnets keep going together, but that's a good one. Here we got some more magnetic pieces. These guys drive me nuts. I hate them. These are literal, like, bead lot stuff, but I guess they're good to fun to play with. When were these popular? Like, I feel like I never ever paid much attention, I guess, until I started loving jewelry the way I do. Oh, this is cool. Nice. This is another good one. This is a lava and olivine in Hawaii. So this is just like a little souvenir thing that you would have gotten when you were out on vacation, maybe. And then we got this little bead. It says shopping. Got another one of these guys. I like this one. I like that style. A good gold one too. I really like gold ones. Oh my god, I can't fit it. It's small. This guy don't have much for stretch, but these are fun to play with. Darlings, darlings, darlings. Here's another scarf clip. Scarf clip. Ooh, this one's pretty. It's enamel on that, I think. It almost looks like enamel. Cool. Oh, look what I got. Look what we found. Oh, what is that? Oh my lord, that's pretty. I don't know what it is though. It's just like, if it's a, is it broken on somewhere? Look at this guy. Oh, wow. I have so many of these. This is like number 5 now. Wow. I have these listed for $50 each. No, I think I have them listed for $75 each. Like, these are and that's like the competitive rate for them on eBay and other places. So these guys are pretty valuable, and I would sell them for much cheaper. Like, I always price high, but I usually always sell usually at 50% of the price that I list it for, especially if you're bundling more than one item. But yeah, like, I'm going to be able to list this guy for $75 if I decide to list it, because red is rare. It's a rare one. I don't see a lot of red. Yay, this is exciting. This one's really exciting. Yay. And then in the bottom of the bag, we got another Reader's Digest, I'm pretty sure that is. And then we got this bead thing somebody made. Random. Okay, let's see what's in the boxes. This must be Avon. This is ceramic. And it is on a gold tone chain. Most of this feels like Avon to me. Like, you know, those beautiful sets Avon used to sell in their catalogs. I just tied a knot in that, y'all. Leave it to Beaver. That's really pretty. This might be my favorite piece. I did tie a knot in it too. I thought that it was kind of funny that they did the earrings round. But what do I know? This might not be the right box for this either. I don't know what I'll be able to list this one for. That's so pretty. And this one is Foster. And look at that. We got a tie clip. Signed on the back. And then we got the little cufflinks. This is nice. I don't do well with selling this stuff though. I don't do well. And then there's this guy. See? This is the Avon stuff I was talking about. I might actually give this to my kid, because she's been really into, like, the cross thing. Like, with the earrings and stuff. Like, she's... The kids are bringing back the 90s, and I am here for all of it. Just saying, like... Okay, yay, we did it. Hooray, we did it. Okay, so here's the first one. And then with Avon Jewelry, they always give you those extenders, which I love, because I cannot stand a 16-inch chain or an 18-inch chain. So you see how it gives you the extenders on the necklaces? I really, really love that. So here's the faux pearl. So here it looks like you get the pearl with the earrings up here, and then you get this pearl pendant, and then you get the cross ones, and then you get these two. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's a lot going on in here. See, I see, I see. And then the earrings. And then you got one more chain over here with the cross. I might actually give this to my kid. She might like this. Or maybe this necklace and earrings. No, it makes sense. All right. Okay, cool. It's just this one doesn't have a home. We're just going to put them in the bottom of the box because
you don't need to be getting all messy.
So that's cool. Okay. That's a good one. I'm happy with that one. I got a few favorites in here, y'all. And then we got one more box, and this box looks really old. Oh, wow. Look at that. Would you look at that? No signature. Oh, yes, there is. Oh, no, that's just the indent. But that's really, really, really cool. This is old. This is from, like, this is old. This is really, really old. Okay, guys. So, this is all just filler now for my jewelry jars. Oh, we got one more little bag. What am I talking about? There's more. God, this was a huge lot. I'm already 40 minutes into this. Okay. look at this. Okay. What is this? Oh, it's a butterfly. There's only one. Why? Oh my goodness. Look at those little sand dollars. Those are beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Oh, just like this little flipping butterfly. Oh my goodness. I wish there was two of you. These are just some little vintage wood earrings. These are probably from the 80s. Definitely from the 80s. Look at the. Oh my god. Oh my god. I love them. Darling. Oh my god. What is this? Another little seashell. Stop. Look. Oh my goodness. Okay. I might be like low-key crazy, but look, like, oh my goodness. Okay, I'm speechless. Those are freaking beautiful. Okay, what else we got going on here? Look. Look at that. Look how pretty those are. I'm like, oh, these are signed. Okay, what are you saying? TF. I think it says 925. I can't see around there. Let's see. I got nothing to hold on to it. My fat fingers ain't working. Ah, I lost my flash. Oh, it's actually kind of bitter. Anyways, these are signed and I'm happy. And they look awesome. Okay, so these are definitely a good set, y'all. I gotta get the lighting back. My phone must be dying. The phone must be dying. Okay, let's get through this. Here's another little guy that signed. I think those are Monet. Beautiful, beautiful. I hate it when my phone dies like right at the end and then I lose my little flashlight on the... So I think these come with the earrings and I'm pretty sure these are just carved little roses. I don't think they're actual like I-V-O-R-Y. Y'all, it's not what you think. And then look at these. Okay, so this is where all the pretty things are. We're hiding. Look. It's resin. But beautiful. I love these little things. These little sets. They're cool. And then we got these little blue earrings. Those are pretty. This is the part that like I don't really care for is the bits and bobs. Even though I'm having a good time right now because all these bits and bobs are making me happy. But look at these chandelier earrings. These are really, really nice too. And then we got this tiny little cloisonné pendant with the little matching earrings. Oh my goodness, they're so cute. Not sure what that came off of. It's just a little pendant. Like, look at these little guys. These little baby butterflies. That's a little set. And then we got these beautiful little earrings. Little dangly guys. I'm really impressed with this lot now. This is just, this little bag has just made me really happy. And then this is a ring set. Looks like this might go together. Oh, yeah. It does not fit me. This would be a size not signed anywhere, but still a nice quality ring. Like, look at the stones in that. This is really pretty set, actually, even though it's not like it's fashion or whatever. Looks like a size 7. Yeah. Just above a 7. 7, that's a good one. And then we got this little Eye of the Tiger gold tone. Not signed. 6.5. Is there any stones missing there? It looks like it could be, yeah. Looks like we got some stones missing. That's okay, though, but not enough to hurt. As long as he's got his eyeballs. There's one missing there in his mouth. And then this guy. Oh, that thing is cold to the touch. This is like a real deal. This is not as even a size 6. And then there's this tiny little guy. And this one would be lucky to be a 6, 5.5. Alright. Okay. I'm happy, y'all. I'm happy. Got some good pieces in here. Got some really nice vintage pieces. Oh, this guy right here too. Look at this one. Got some really nice vintage pieces in here that I'll be able to list and set up like separately to be able to make my money back for sure. And then I have a whole lot that I can put into jars. So I'm pretty sure I got like this less than $30. I don't know. I'll have to put it up on the screen for y'all to see what I paid for it. And then I'll put the seller's closet so you can go check out her closet as well. Follow them if you are on Poshmark. And yeah, I think I did good. I definitely got a few pieces I can pull out for reselling in my closet. And then I also got stuff to add to jars. So I love sourcing on Poshmark, and this was a good source. Oh, here's another little thing. This was a good lot. I call this a good lot. Lots of fun little pieces in there. Some marked, some not. I love Avon jewelry. Like, I'm a sucker for Avon. Sorry. I love me my Avon, y'all. But yeah, thanks for joining me. Please subscribe. Let me know what your favorite piece was in the comments. And we'll see you on the next one. Bye.